Our new electricity grid doesn't need to function like the old one, and forcing it to do so would be highly inefficient. And I think that most people don't really get how transformative flexible demand is going to be, and so they massively underestimate its potential. There are still uncertainties to be resolved. For example, people say that a system with a lot of flexible demand would be too chaotic, that we can't rely on individual households to reduce demand when needed. So grid planners would need to design the system to be robust without it, which means putting in all the generation and all the transmission you'd need if there was no flexibility, thereby totally eliminating the point. I don't believe that will be the case, because the electricity grid already relies on households behaving in pretty predictable ways on aggregate. As an example, if every house in Australia turned their toaster on at the same time, it would create an additional 12 gigawatts load. That is nearly half of our average grid load. If that came on at once, it would crash the grid for sure. No one freaked out about the electricity grid when electric toasters started finding their way into every household. So now consider the question of EVs and the fear that is often raised that everyone will plug in when they get home from work at 6 p.m. That would be like the toaster example on steroids. That just cannot happen if we want our grid to continue to function. And so far it's not happening. Houses with EVs are commonly also houses with rooftop solar, and there are very strong financial incentives for them to use that solar power instead of sending it to the grid. So they tend to charge their EVs during the day. Another common criticism I hear about demand response is that no one is going to want to be inconvenienced. When people flick a light switch, they expect the lights to come on instantly. But many people are willing to make sacrifices to save small amounts of money. Every now and then I see articles about long lines at petrol stations because someone has dropped their prices. Their customers are willing to wait for hours to save maybe 20 or 30 bucks. The same principle will surely apply to energy consumption. But still, it's not everyone that's like that. We'll need digital technologies like smart chargers, smart hot water systems, smart thermostats to get much easier to integrate and much more popular before demand response can meet its true potential. The difference in cost between a dumb electricity grid without demand response and one where it's widely prevalent is too great for it to not happen.